Devastated Marcorp customers have reacted with heartache and anger after the company collapsed, leaving hundreds of homes unfinished. Many fear they could lose their deposits, claiming the business failed to take out proper insurance. Reid Butler has today's developments.
Nikki and Ryan had grand plans when they put down their $24,000 home deposit.
Have another baby, get a dog, that white picket fence lifestyle.
Now they face the prospect of losing their hard-earned money.
This is now our reality and there may never be a home here. When we did this, we never thought that this would happen to us.
Properties from Urban Edge and 8 homes under Marcorp in limbo after the company entered voluntary administration. Nikki Estrada has spent around $300,000 on her build at this Clyde estate.
I've put my heart and soul into it for my son. I've worked so hard to get where I am now and there's no answers and I just want to know what's happening.
Patrick's home, also unfinished.
My wife is friendly, so I don't know how to begin, you know.
Nikki and Ryan believe Marcorp failed to take out mandatory domestic building insurance when it took their money.
We're just a bit baffled at the lack of protection, if that is the case.
Porter Davis did the same, meaning more than 500 customers lost their deposits.
And this appears to be a systemic problem in the industry. What we need now is the Andrews government to step up, to take the appropriate action when it comes to what the regulator needs to do.
A one-off government scheme will compensate the Porter Davis home buyers, but Marcorp told Nine News their customers' deposits are safe for now, as the company is not in liquidation.
Construction on more than 700 homes, including this one, has now been halted, and it will stay that way for at least the next 5 weeks, as the company urgently assesses its business operation.
Until then, the agonising wait continues. Reid Butler, Nine News.